My name is Giorgia Garrett, and we're at the University of California, San Francisco Medical Center. I'm the clinical research fellow here in the lab, and I look at transplant patients and why they develop skin cancer. So my dad is a biochemist, and he got his PhD from UCSF, and I grew up around science. I loved biology, chemistry, physics, mathematics at school. I loved learning about different chemicals and doing different things in the lab when I was in high school, and so I decided to go into medical school and become an MD. This year is a special year for me. The name research fellowship just means that you're an MD looking at a particular aspects of research that interests you, so you're focused on research rather than on patient contact. So what I do is I read papers, I write papers, I meet patients, but in a clinical trial, in a pharmaceutical study, in a different types of setting rather than me being their doctor. I look at data, I collect data, I analyze it using Excel, using REDCap, different statistical tools, and I try and think of how we can learn about new things we don't know about and how we can think about things differently. Dermatology is the study of the skin, and the skin is the biggest organ in the body. So it's very relevant to the human body. Obviously, during your medical school training as MDs, you will go through different organs, different parts of the body, and the skin stuck with me. It's a very visual organ. You can do fun stuff to it. You can color it, you can laser it, you can cut it, you can sew it, you can just look at it, you can do many different things, and it's just a very fun and interesting specialty. So you can help people by being on the front line in medicine and being better MDs or nurses, or you don't have to be a doctor to help people in medicine. You can also help people by doing research and looking for things we don't know how to treat or what they are. And, you know, you're sort of making a difference from a different perspective. So what I look at here is I look at patients who have been given lungs from other people. So you take your lungs out and you put a new lung in, and that's called a transplant. And the thing about transplants is that our immune systems tend to attack whatever foreign part is in us. So if I had somebody else's lungs, my immune system would attack him. And we give them drugs to suppress that. And the consequence is that they get a lot of skin cancer, these patients, and we don't know why. So there's a link between suppressing the immune system and getting skin cancer, which is what I'm looking at. And if I, or the bigger initiative I'm part of, am successful in finding what this is, this could help a lot of people who have lung transplants not die or suffer from skin cancer. So research and medical school are different paths, and you can be a doctor who has an emphasis on research, but that's just one side of being a doctor. In order to be good at research, you need to like spending time alone, you need to like science, and you need to like being very precise about things. It's fun, you need to like colors, smells, you know, you can make mistakes and blow things up and have to construct them again from scratch. To be a doctor, you need to like people, and you need to like healing people, and you need to like seeing a lot of things, you know, like blood and, you know, a lot of things that you don't normally see in normal life. And a lot of doctors think that's fun, and that's one of the reasons why they like it. You know, we have pieces of skin and pieces of people, you know, stored in our fridge or freezer that we can take out and look at and see what's going on in the cell inside and see the world that is, you know, that makes us. What keeps me going is the beauty of science is that it's not man-made. It's a world of its own, which we don't know much about, which we're learning more about, which we don't have any control over, which doesn't behave under the rules that the normal world behaves under, such as the law or the sort of civil system that we've put in place. It's you get a piece of skin, you get a microscope, and you can go to the cellular level and see what the cell is doing. And then within the cell, you can go to an organelle and see what that's doing. And you can go so small that we can't even imagine what the size is. And we could even go smaller, but we don't know how to do that yet. And to me, that's absolutely fascinating.